sine nobis Domine misericordiam tuam. Sanctum Angelum tuum de trellis, quicest of the earth of the earth, autocra, visited aqua, defended all the summons and the baddest in all capitapolo, per Christum dominum nostrum. Thank you. Gloria in, Gloria in excelsis Deo. Dominica Nignata Pietate Custodi, Onque in Solus Pei Grazi Celestis Intuito, Tua Semper Predexus Moniato, Per Dominum Nostrum Ies in Christum Delium Tuum, We take and vivid regnat in adapte Spiritus Sancti Deus, Per Omnia Saecula Saeculorum. Lectio Epistolae Beati Italia Apostoli a Colossense. Fratres, intuitu vos sic et electi Dei, sancte et electi viscere misericordiae, benignitatem, humilitatem, modestiam, patientiam, supportalis in vicem et donates, vos me ipsus qui quis, adversus alocram habet querulam, Sigure Dominus donavit vobis, iter quos. Sub omne autem haec caritate habete, quod est vinculum perfectionis, et pax Christi exultet in cordibus festris, in quaeret vocati estis in unum corpore, et gratia est dote. Verbum Christi habited in verbis abundantur, in omnis sapientia decendus, et commentus vos me ipsos famus hymnus, in canibus spiritualibus, in gratia cantatis in cordibus, vestris Deo. Omne quodcunque facitis in verbi ad in opere, omni in nomine Domini Jesu Christi. Gratias agendas Deo, et Pace per Iesum Christum, Domine nostrum.
Iero stil.
Dominus Vobiscum.
Et cum Spiritu Tuo.
Sequentia Sancti Evangelii Seconda Matteo.
Gloria tibi Domine.
In illo tempore, dixit Jesus tibis paulum heng, simile factum est in nuncialorum homini, qui semen avibonum semen in acro suo, cum autem domi erant homines, venit in minico seas et super semen avib, cisani et meretrici et abuis, cum autem crevesit herba, et fructum fecit tunc apparent et cisania, ascendentes autem servit pater familias, dixon e domine non e bonum semen, seminasti in agro tuo, unde erga habet cisania, et etilus seminicus homo hoc feci, serviatum dixerent eci, vis imos, et colligimus ea, et et non, ne forte colligentis cisania, eradicetus simo cum eus et triticum, siniti iudeque quisceriusque et mesum, et in tempora mesus dicam missoribus, collicet de primim cisania, et allegate in vaculos, et comprehendum triscicum autum, congregati in horia meum.
For this, the 24th Sunday after Pentecost, readings from the 5th after Epiphany. Please take home a copy of the bulletin and please read it. Make sure you've filled in your list for the November Holy Souls, and if you haven't already done so. Traditional St. Joseph's calendars and Christmas cards available after Mass at the entrance or from the cafe. Community Garden Club meeting and farm, meeting on Thursday, 11th of November at 7:15 p.m. after the evening mass with Father Brian Limborn. So he'll be chairing the meeting after mass on Thursday. Thanks to all those volunteers and all those who help in the cafe and fulfil the corporal works of mercy. Cafe menu today, eggplant and meat parmigiana with salad, caldereta beef and rice, and fish and chips with salad, and the usual things as well. Thank you for all the prayers for the appeal action on Wednesday. As the decision has been reserved, this means the result is not known. So please keep it in your prayers that we receive a favourable result. Thank you for your prayers and support, and please keep praying for this intention. Now, we hear in the Gospel today, the kingdom of heaven is likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. Now, holiness is one of the marks of the true church, together with universality, apostolic origin and unity. Holiness is one of the four attributes of the true church, found in the Nicene Creed, which you've been studying with Father Limborn in the history class. We say in the Creed, et unum sanctum catholicum et apostolicum. So if our Lord founded the church, then that which he founded must be holy, radically holy. Nonetheless, we are faced with two serious realities. We see an increased unholiness in our people, And even worse, we see an increased unholiness in our clergy. In years past, Catholics, and especially priests and nuns, had a generally untarnished reputation for holiness and keeping good morals. Today, we might say it is not so much. Could this possibly mean that we are mistaken about which church is the true church? After all, it is supposed to be holy, and it doesn't seem to be. However, if we look around the world, we see other broken away churches seems to have all yielded to the spirit of the age. For the most part, non-Catholic churches have simply changed their teachings to permit unholy and immoral behaviour, getting away from the fact that people are committing sins, so just legalising the sin. Now, here in Australia, it was originally the Protestant churches of previous centuries that made laws against moral evils like prostitution, conception, sodomy, divorce, and abortion. For Catholics, of course, lacked any political power. But it was these same Protestant churches that gradually came to accept many or all of these evil behaviours, allowing the laws to liberalise and giving everyone the false idea that evil had suddenly become good. As we know, it is now illegal in some cases to question even if these evils are actually evil. As we know, for example, to even assert that marriage is between a man and a woman, one can be accused of a hate crime and being a bigot. Now, our Lord anticipated this concern about the holiness of his church in the Gospel today. He describes his kingdom as a mixture of good and bad, as weeds amongst the wheat. Now, the church is holy in her founder, our Lord Jesus himself, unique amongst all the religions. It is founded by God and not by sinful men. The householder in the parable then represents our Lord, who sowed good seed and has every right to expect a good crop of wheat. It is only because an enemy has come into his field that things have gone wrong. The devil and those foolish enough to follow him have introduced the weeds of evil in God's holy church. But if we look at the church is always holy in all her doctrines. This should surprise no one, for she teaches what our Lord taught. She counsels the observance of the Ten Commandments for doing good works and spiritual perfection. She asks us to imitate our Lord and his Blessed Mother Mary. And by making ourselves like Jesus and Mary, it is impossible to be anything other than holy. Yet there are those weeds amongst the wheat, which we must ignore. No one, no matter how highly placed in the church, or for that matter in civil society, should allow us to sway away from these Christ-given principles of holiness. We have the example of centuries of Catholics who suffered first the persecution under the Jews, then the Romans, then the false Christian persecutions in the first millennium, then Protestantism, the French Revolution, and modern persecutions of socialism and communism. But there can be no compromise of the faith by Catholics today. Now, we have all heard of supposedly needs to modernise church teaching and doctrine and get away from the church's traditional teachings on marriage and Holy Communion and other such things. Of course, churches that have got away from the teaching of Christ, the net result has that people have left those churches and walked away because they are no longer holy. And if we continue the metaphor of wheat amongst the weeds, or weeds amongst the wheat, we can say that the church is equipped with powerful weed killers that we should use frequently. The holy sacrifice of the Mass, the sacraments, and sacramentals, especially the rosary and the scapula. The officially defined moral and doctrinal principles, and the collective wisdom of all the saints in pursuit of holiness. So if the modern decline in holiness in the church seems overwhelming, remember that we are not alone. The church is holy in her members, at least those amongst the wheat. Those publicly known, the canonised saints, those unknown that we celebrated on All Saints Day, not canonised, yet saints in heaven, and those in purgatory who will eventually become saints, the holy souls. And, of course, there are holy people on earth who sacrifice and pray and devote their lives to doing God's will and spreading his words. All of these saints may be important people high in the church or just simple people like ourselves. So on All Saints Day, I said, we are all called to be saints. Do not be disturbed by the unholy in the church. They are here in fulfilment of the prophecy today. The weeds amongst the wheat. Simply strive to be sure that you are counted amongst the wheat rather than among the weeds. Frequent Mass, confession, Holy Communion, a constant and regular prayer life, keeping the Ten Commandments and the six precepts of the Church, doing good works for love of God and love of neighbour. In these ways, we become holy. So don't be amongst the cockle, bound into bundles at the end of time to be burned forever. Be amongst the wheat gathered into God's storehouse, being radically holy. And take St. Paul's epistle words to heart. All whatever you do in word or work or in deed, all things do you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God and the Father through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Ghost.
Praetor aeternum Deo.
Et in nudum Domino, Jesu Christum, filium Dei unigenitum,
session.
Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sursum corda. Gratias ergamus, Domino Deo nostro.
Dignum et justum est.
Veri dignum et justum est, tecum et salutare. Nos tibi semper dubique gratias agere. Dominus sanctum pater omnipotens et ene Deus. Qui cum unigenito filio tuo, et spiritus sanctus est Deus, unus est Dominus, non in ingle singulitate personae, sed in unus trinitate substantiae, quod enim deter gloria revelante te credimus, hoc te filio tuo, hoc de spiritui sancto, sine differentia discretionis sensimus, ut in conversione veris sempiternique deitatis, et in personas profietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate adorator qualitas, quam laudan antili acque acrandrili, cervin quoque ex erefim, qui nascum ad quotidie, una voce dicente. Sanctus, sanctus, sanctus. Nobis quaeque peccatoribus. Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus bishop de salutaribus monarchi, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, via voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini et semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Domine non sunt ignis. Domine non sunt ignis. Miserata vesti omnipotens Deus et miserabilis vestis begut of vos et vita mater. Indigentia matis et missionem peccatorum vestrum tibi verbis omnipotens misericordes Dominus. Et in este ecce catholo peccato mundi, Domine non sunt ignis et in vis de cubam satani de verbis sabida anima mea. Domine non sunt ignis et in vis de cubam satani de verbis sabida anima mea. Domine non sunt ignis et in vis de cubam
Yeah.
Benedicat vos Dominus Sabiscum. Initium Sancti Evangelii Secundum Johannem. In principio verbum potem deus verbum caritas principio deum. Omnes factus sonus in esse factum est in esse factum est in esse vita et vita lux omnem. Et lux in esse tenet tenuna comprenduit. Fiat omnes misericordiae cum in omeratio haes, ec ven testimonium praeter lumen. Amus Godem per lumen, non ever lux ad est manem per et illumine. Ere lux fere quae lumen omnem omnem venum mundum. In mundum erat, munus factus est, munus ea nocuc nevit, in propter venit ul sol main in tripper. Quocanum in tripper in dedit est festanum fidis tiri fiut. Es crimini es quina nec sanguinis neques, volantanis neques, volantare vir, sed exterre non hi sunt. Et babum cari factum est, et habitar vidi nec. Et venimus goies quod quasi ingenii patrae, penium gratiae et veritate.